1, is made from number 28 gauge copper enamel coated or Formvar magnet wire. 14 turns, close wound over the outside diameter of L2, in the center of L2. Plastic electrical tape is wrapped around L1 to form a smooth surface for winding. After winding the 14 turns, wrap additional tape to hold L1 in place. The capacitors C1 and C2 are the most difficult to build and are the critical key item to success or failure in producing results. The foil from two capacitors, pyramid electrolytic TM58, must be removed from the can that encloses the foil by cutting the top or bottom off with a hacksaw or other cutting device. The coiled foil is removed from two capacitors and spread out on a flat table. A TM58 capacitor should measure, including foil and paper, 91 and 1/8 inches long and 2¾ inches wide. Wipe off excess electrolytic solution so that it is dry. One side of the paper holding the foil will be full length. The opposite side will be split, with terminal connections appearing at each end of the split portion. The capacitors that were used in the early experiments had a gap between the split foil of 3/4 inch. Prepare two cylinders of metal with dimensions of 5¼ inches in diameter by 2¾ inches wide. A stainless steel sheet metal 0.032 thick was used in Hendershot cylinders, open at both ends. Before wrapping begins, insulate the cylinders with pure craft paper. Ordinary brown wrapping paper is unsatisfactory, as it contains impurities. Wax paper might be used as a substitute. If you want more information about the Hendershot generator, please click the link below.